Hey guys, Ole Anderson here from the Berkshire, Massachusetts treasure hunter. So I figured I would do a little update on all my freshwater tanks. This one here is a Petco Imagineterium, I guess they're called. I don't know if I pronounced this right. It got a king beta in it. It's a 3.75 gallon, so that's probably the minimum I would go for a betta fish. It's an all-in-one tank. It's been in there for about a year. It has some plans to keep it company. And it's pretty happy in there. I mean, he could probably use a 5 gallon, but so far he's been doing awesome. He's a pretty happy fish. So, got a POTUS plant to suck up nutrients. A light from eBay, the old light burned out. It grows these low light plants okay. Like I said, it's an all-in-one tank. Got some Seacam Purigen and some bio balls in there. That's all he had. He gets water change every week, about a quarter of it, so like a gallon or so. He's a happy camper. Here's my daughter's new tank. It's a 8.75 gallon. Kind of expensive. And the glue work is not the best in the world, but I do like this view. You can view up top. She just got fish in it today. I think she got 5 platies. And a betta fish, so he's kind of a happy camper too. So got some dragon stone stacked up in there, some live plants. It came with the soil. I'm not quite sure what that is, if it's clay balls or something. I know these plants back here is withering away. I don't think the light is good enough for that, but the crypts on that and he's down here doing okay, so hopefully they'll be doing okay. Again, a tank from Petco. It has a little internal filter and a LED light. It came with this. That was the first thing I took out and threw it away. If you have stuff like that, it's a waste of money. It's just a money maker for the fish stores. As you can see straight to the sponge. It's not gonna catch much, and then you got a tiny little bit of carbon and some filter floss in a pouch. So yeah, I wouldn't use that. I mean, you can. It's just a lot of money wasted. Make your own material. I mean, put your own stuff in. I have bio balls and Purigen in this one too. So, but as you can see, the tank goes them up and then it comes up and then it goes up here. So you got this extra viewing window. It's 8.75 designer LED tank. So yeah, so it's not a bad little tank. Expensive for what it is, but I had to put an air stone in there too for some more movement. I mean, the filter is doing an okay job, I guess. So yeah, so there's four or five platies and the betta fish. So yeah, so it's doing okay. They just got put in there today and they seem happy, so there'll probably be some babies soon if this is male. Some are male and female. I mean, I think it's females, I'm not sure. Like I said, everything is from Petco too. It's the only local fish store I have in the area, except for the dragon stone I ordered online. So I do order lights and stuff online. You got a little Aquagon heater, preset heater to 78 degrees. But as you can see, he's a pretty happy camper. There's not much flow in there, so it's just fine for him. So yeah. Okay, let's go out and see my 20-gallon long guppy tank. Before we see the guppy tank, here's a 10-gallon shrimp tank. Again, Petco tank. All the plants are from Petco. The sponge filters are from Wish, the Wish app. See if we can catch a little shrimp. There's one right there. I just fed them a while ago, so they're eating that. I don't know if you can see it, but it's right there in the middle. They all lost their color, I don't know why. There were cherry shrimp and a mono. The cherry shrimps all lost their color. I think, no, that's an Amano. But as you can see, he's eating pretty good. There's like 10 of them in here, and they have had babies, so they have their own little paradise in here. There's some Nereid snails to keep the tank clean. So yeah, all in all, easy little tank. Just with a regular light and aqua clear little filter and a sponge filter. So yeah, okay, on to the 20 gallon. So here's the 20 gallon long planted tank. As you can see, I have a bit of a snail infestation, not infection. I do have some what do you call them, assassin snail in there, but they're not doing a very good job. I can't keep up. And the only thing I have in here is guppies. They have babies all the time, so it's a self-regulating tank with population. I do have two loaches in here, and I think they take a guppy snack every once in a while. I got two sponge filters. And again, a POTUS plant. And a bigger aqua clear filter. The LED is a Phoenix, I think, 24/7. Regular heater. The decor is from Petco. Again, most of it is from Petco. Tank from Petco. Actually, the light and the spun filters are online. So yeah, this is my 20 gallon. I just let it grow however it wants. And see what kind of guppies I can make here. So yeah, this was my freshwater tank. I guess we can do a little update on the saltwater tank. Let's go over to the saltwater tank. Not much has happened here. As you can see, it's all blue. the light is on the down spiral turning off. What calls are doing fairly good. They're not too happy right now because I just did a water change about a couple hours ago. So, but yeah, the tank is doing great. This is a Innovated Marine. The Fusion 40 or Nuvo Fusion 40. I can never remember what is what. It got those live rocks with infused with painted with bacteria. Got a bunch of coral frags in here. They're doing okay. I got a Jabo wave maker, a Hooker light. I mean a Hooker heater, and a Mighty Jet pump. I got two Prime HD. To take care of all the corals. There are corals up top. Need some extra lights, so hopefully they'll be fine. I run with the in-tank media basket, and it came with a Innovative Marine media basket over there. And this side, I just run filter floss, Boich blue, and Seacam Puritan. And this chamber over here is full of Marine Pure Bio Balls, and the same with this, full of Marine Pure Bio Balls and some filter floss here. Right here, we got the little refugium. As you can see, there's algae in there. As long as they stay in there, I'm fine with that. And the tomato is growing, so I change about half of it every week. I'm gonna turn the light off for now. I'll turn it on when I go to bed. I bought 1,000, so they say, couple pots or pots for the tank, little critters. They're all in the sand bottom. It was buy 1,000, get 1,000 free from Aquarium Depot. I can highly recommend that. They all came well and alive. But yeah, the corals are doing fine. This is still a new tank. It's just maturing. There's not going anything in it anymore. When it's about 6 months old or so, I will try with some rock flowers and anemones and see how they're doing. And maybe a bubble tip, maybe. Maybe I'll get rid of some of these frags, see how they're doing though. Some of them don't like the strong light. The up top they do, this is from Petco, this letter is not that happy. I don't know why, if I should move it down further. If anybody know about letter calls, where should I put it in the tank? I try and do what they say. High flow, high light, low flow, low light. Doesn't seem too happy. But everything else is fine. They're growing pretty good. So yeah, all in all, it's been a pretty good tank. I quick started it with fridge turbo start and a little bit of fish food, and it was ready for corals in 7 days. So I put some coral frags in, and then a week later I added the fish. So yeah, so this is a great little tank, no issues at all. Have a hawkfish, a coral beauty, a lawnmower blini, and 2 clownfish. That's probably what I'm going to keep with for right now. So yeah, so it's just a little Sunday update, mostly about my freshwater tanks. You all have a nice Sunday evening. And if you like this kind of content, press subscribe and like, and I'll be posting some more. In about 3 or 4 months, we're going to go back to bottle hunting. So I hope the aquarium people that's on this channel of mine don't mind bottle hunting in the summer, and I hope the bottle hunters don't mind aquarium stuff in the winter. I'll still update a bit of my fish tanks in the summer, but it's mostly going to be about bottles, and in the winter time it's mostly going to be about fish tanks. So I live in New England, I can't, well I could, but I don't want to go bottle hunt right now, too cold. So, but like I said, you all have a nice Sunday. Later.